This is one of my favorite trails in the area. This section up here is absolutely stunning. And it's rewarding because you've had to come up some nasty stuff to get here. And then this is gonna be, you know, downhill basically the rest of the way. Short little loop back to the staging area. But this section is just like the reward because you've done some nasty stuff to get here. And then you can enjoy it. And it's still, and this part of the trail is like the cool, peaceful, beautiful part. And then as we get going down further, it's gonna become steeper, nastier, rockier, but you're going downhill, so it's not as hard as coming up on this one. This one's a beast to come up. I've done it, obviously, but it's a beast. So, and that wind is cold. I mean, you can see there's snow on these south-facing slopes and stuff like this, and the wind is just whipping. I mean, it was 45 degrees down at the truck when I left, I don't know, an hour ago or something. Up here, that wind chill is just frickin' freezing. It's probably around 30 or so degrees, I would say, wind chill factor. But it's okay. We got layers on and we're heading downhill. So it's gonna get, we're gonna get out of the wind as we continue down, and it'll warm as we drop elevation. We gotta drop 1,000 or 2,000 feet. So that'll be good. But yeah, this is just such a beautiful area up here. One of those. Oh, I gotta adjust my idle up. I don't want the bike dying like that. Somebody dug out a little right there, obviously stuck somehow. So this section of the trail I haven't been through this year. Wonder how much stuff I'm gonna need to cut out, if any. Some of those, a lot of those saplings on the other side I cut out earlier in the year. In June or July, whatever it was. Those aspen saplings. Yeah, I gotta try to get the idle up. Cooking now. You're like, well, it's not cooking, but it's cooking with this freaking terrain, those rocks. That's cooking because it's steeper than frick, and those rocks are just looser than hell. It's so many of them bouncing all over. Just kind of skating down, picking lines, letting the front fork do its magic. Bike's literally gonna die if I don't adjust the idle up. I'm trying to keep the dang thing running. Oh my gosh, that looks so good. That dirt, it smells so good. Oh, oh, Kyle. Horses are coming up this and struggling. You can tell. Oh, I'm about high-sided right there. You know it's a bloody steep trail when you can tell horses were digging deep to get up that. Oh, come on, Kyle. See that, all this is challenging to come up because all that is rock. Big, loose, nasty rocks where you have no traction and no good lines. They're all like baseball size to cantaloupe size rocks that are just loose and rolling, and so it makes it pretty dang challenging. I'm gonna try to get the idle up on this sucker. I think it's the top one, right? Nope, that's the wrong way. There we go. So glad that's finger adjustable. And that's about perfect. Now I don't need to worry about the bike dying. I don't want it to be crazy high, but I don't want to have to consciously try and keep the bike running with my throttle hand. I got too much to worry about, to have to worry about that. See, these horses are digging up the trail just as bad as anybody, just as bad as a dirt bike. But horses don't usually ever get kicked off trails. Dirt bikes do. Even though a horse can create more havoc on a trail than a person. But because they don't have motors, and people have a fascination with horses, and because they're quiet, they don't get demonized. like motorized travel does. People have a romanticized view and relationship with horses. I feel like so horses get away with stuff like they're supposed to be. Like, horses create shiz tons of thistles up on mountain trails because they carry the seeds in their crap, and so then they'll crap along the side of the trail because they've eaten like thistle heads, because when thistle heads are fresh and blooming, they're like a tasty treat for horses. Horses love them, and so they eat them. And then they come up here, crap out those thistle seeds, and then they grow like crazy and take over some of the mountain trails. I've seen that happen. So they sit there and they say they want, you know, you to, if you're gonna bring your horse up into the forest, you're supposed to have like certified weed-free hay. Well, first off, how many horse people are doing that? And then it doesn't matter that much either, because they were eating the freaking thistles in some cases, not all cases, right? But some cases down on the mountain before they came up with their certified weed-free hay. And now they're spreading thistle seeds. So, yeah. That can be a problem. I've seen it through the years. But they've been up here. There's some fresh horse crap. So being careful, because like, I don't want to roll up too fast, because I can see freshish horse crap. I didn't look at it closely enough to see if it could have been last night, but it looks like they've been here today. Oh, son of a. That went over the bars on that.